Hey there, do you buy a lot of goods on Amazon.com and constantly have to go log in before knowing what the things are to classify them in your QuickBooks Online? Well, look what I found. In my latest edition of my series, where we look at new features as they're introduced into QuickBooks Online, there's a new integration for Amazon Business. In my series, where I take a look at new features in QuickBooks Online, there's a new integration for Amazon Business. So let's take a look and see how it works. So where I am right now is in my banking center, and I can get there either by clicking on transactions or banking in the left-hand side. Normally, you're over here in banking, but notice that there's another tab right next to it that says app transactions. Here I can see that there's integrations for Amazon and for Square. We'll cover that one in another video later. I'm going to click Connect Free App, and it gives me an interstitial, which advertises the service, and I'll go ahead and click Continue. And it wants to know, when do I want to bring in my information from? I don't want to go that far back. So I'm going to type T to go to today, and then Y to go back to January 1st of this year, and I'll click Agree. Now it asks me to log in, so I'll go ahead and pick my login. I'm also going to tell it to keep me signed in. And now we're going to have to wait a moment for the one-time password code. So you might have to wait and put in a code. All right, so now it's connected. Let's check it out. I do have a notice here that says it may take a while to bring in all of the transactions. So I'm going to click on Refresh now. All right, there's some of them. It's not all of them. Now, I have another warning sign right here. Confirm accounts for your payment methods. To make sure your accounting is right, confirm the accounts in QuickBooks you use for your payment methods. Now, this is extremely important. So I'm going to confirm them. Notice that I've got several different payment methods, and that's because different employees are all charging their department accounts. This one is personal. So I'm going to make sure that that one goes to what I call my Bank of Bob, but that's the checking account that I use for all personal expenses. And then later on, I move all of that to owner investment. That's another video. 5334 is one of my checking accounts. That one goes to the Chase 50 account. The one that says 9560 is also actually all wrapped up into that account as well. And I'll click Save. And I know that I have some other accounts to map. So I'm going to click on App Settings. Here, this one, 1950, this one's actually mapped to the wrong account. So I'm going to click on the pencil and change this one to my 1950 card. And this one, the 9560 card, gets mapped to, actually, that's an old card number, but I know that it gets mapped to that account. So I'll click Save on that one as well. Now, notice here that you also have default payment methods for gift cards. And so it will actually create an Amazon credit in your account because it's a funding source. If you are doing accounts payable, you can. There's also that possibility for credit memos as well. So I'll click Done on those settings. Now, anytime I classify one of the transactions from here, it will go to the right funding source. And I do have several screens worth. Now, look at this. Some of these already here from the 1950 card are already in the system. So it's recognizing them. Instead of creating duplicates or creating new ones, all I have to do is go in and just say that these are matches to existing transactions. So I'll go ahead and click Match on all of those, or I could put check marks to the left of them and accept those right there. And lo and behold, even more of them pop up. Now I'm going to go back to my previous screen and let's take a look at some of the other things that are in here. So this one, for example, this is a return of one of our items. So it gives me the opportunity to say what category it originally came from. And this, our video lights are in office supplies. If you are using classes and locations, you can put those in as well. So I'm going to put those to overhead for both the class and the location. The payee, I'm going to leave on Amazon Business. I don't track which seller I got the product from, but you could. The memo about what you purchased will always travel with the transaction. And down at the bottom, there's even a direct link to the order so that you can get to it later on. So I'm going to go ahead and add that one. It is a two-way street. If I go back to the banking center, any of the transactions that I coded in there will also show up here as well. So I make sure that I'm on my 1950 account, ask it to filter just for the ones that it recognizes. Lo and behold, here's the Amazon Marketplace refund that I just processed. And it's again matching an already existing transaction, so I can confirm it. I am in love with the new Amazon integration. Also, if you happen to have personal charges that are on it, those are really easy to exclude. I can check them off and then exclude them. And then because those were from a personal source, then I don't have to worry about them being in my QuickBooks at all. So I'll exclude those. So this is Alicia Katz Pollock from RoyalWise.com. If you enjoyed this video, please like it and share it. Join me at RoyalWise.com, where I have over 40 different QuickBooks online training videos. You can purchase any one course for lifetime evergreen access, or you can join my mentorship program for a stupidly low price. You can watch all the videos in my entire library and become a QuickBooks Online certified pro. I'll look for you there, and I'll see you in class.